In this section, I will look at configuring IP version 6. IP version 6 has been around since the late 1990s, and since then, the adoption of the protocol has been slow. Why the need for IP version 6? Well, since IP version 4 was first introduced, the world has changed. Since then, there have been significant increases in bandwidth and a need for greater security, just to name two of the new challenges facing computing. In this video, I will first look at the improvements that IP version 6 has to offer over IP version 4. There are quite a few good reasons to use the new protocol, if you are able to. Next, I will look at the IP version 6 address. The IP version 6 address uses 128-bit addresses, which is 4 times larger than the IP version 4 address. The first address we will look at is the global unicast address. This is similar to the IP version 4 public address. Next, we will look at the link local address. This address is a special address used in IP version 6 to communicate on the local network. The last address we will look at is the unique local address, which is the equivalent of the private address used in IP version 4. We will then look at the state of IP version 6 addresses. IP version 6 addresses have a life cycle they follow. Depending on where the IP address is in its life cycle, you may or may not be able to use it. IP version 6 can look a little daunting at first, but once you learn the basics, it becomes a lot easier to understand and use. With IP version 6, there are a lot of improvements over IP version 4. First, there is a larger address space. One of the problems with IP version 4 is that we are running out of IP addresses. There have been some studies done that have concluded that we will run out of free IP addresses by the end of 2010. This does not sound good at all, but also consider that a lot of IP addresses in the old days were handed out very wastefully. Since then, a number of systems have been developed to reduce the number of IP addresses that any organization needs, so as to help conserve free IP addresses. You may find that in the future, a lot of these wasted IP addresses will be reclaimed and handed back, delaying the day when we have no more free IP version 4 addresses. It is difficult to predict what is going to happen, but rest assured, if you already have an IP version 4 address registered, you will be able to keep using it even after all the IP addresses have been allocated. Also, even if there are no more IP addresses left for sale, a lot of ISPs will have a lot of free IP addresses that they will continue to hand out until they are all gone. To give you an idea of how many more addresses IP version 6 has, think of it this way. If all the IP addresses were grains of sand, then all the IP version 4 addresses would fill a dump truck. On the other hand, if all the IP version 6 addresses were grains of sand, they would fill the sun. This, as you can imagine, is a huge increase of IP addresses. IP version 6 also offers more efficient routing. The IP version 4 network grew as the need grew, and thus the network was not organized in any well-thought-out manner. IP version 6 addresses are based on a hierarchical and geographical approach. Because of this, the number of the routes in the backbone router on the internet can significantly be reduced. Currently, an internet backbone router can have something like 85,000 routes in it. As you can imagine, this is difficult to manage. IP version 6 significantly reduces the number of routes required on a backbone router, making routing faster and improving efficiency. With IP version 6, the protocols allow simple automatic configuration. Plug in a device, and it will automatically allocate itself an IP address without the need for a DHCP server. This address will only work on the local network. For routable addresses, you can use a DHCP server or a router to allocate an IP address to the client or even manually assign one. IP version 6 offers built-in security using IPsec. IP version 4 can use IPsec, but there is no native support. IP version 6 can use IPsec without the need for significant configuration and infrastructure. Having native support ensures that all hosts can use encrypted transmissions. IP version 6 offers greater quality of service features. In IP version 4, these features were limited to particular ports. With IP version 6, you can place priority information inside the header. This means that IPsec packets can also use quality of service features. As you can see, IP version 6 has a lot of great features, but in the real world, it will take a long time before IP version 6 becomes the default protocol used on the internet. One of the most noticeable changes between IP version 4 and IP version 6 is the size of the address. IP version 6 uses a 128-bit address. To give you an idea of how many addresses that is, with roughly 6.5 billion people on the Earth, there would be 5 × 10^28 addresses for each person on the planet. The 128 bits are broken down into two parts. The first part is the 64-bit ID, or in IP version 6 terminology, this is known as the network prefix. The second part is the 64-bit host ID, or in IP version 4 terminology, this is known as the interface identifier. Since one host can have multiple interfaces, IP version 6 uses the term interface ID rather than host ID. The interface ID is generated from the 48-bit MAC address of the network card, or randomly generated. With the change in address size also comes a change in how the IP addresses are formatted. The 128-bit address is broken down to two parts. As stated, the first 64 bits is the network prefix, and the second 64 bits is the interface identifier. The network address is divided up into three parts. First, the prefix. Next, you have a 45-bit global routing prefix. This part is unique to the network it is on. The last 16 bits can be allocated by the ISP or individual however they like for subnetting. In other words, for each public IP version 6 address, there are 16 bits for networks or over 65,000 networks available. You may also notice that by having a fixed subnet like this, you no longer have to worry about doing those binary conversions to work out subnetting like you did in IP version 4. Before we look at the different types of IP addresses, first of all, it helps to look at how IP version 6 addresses are formatted. IP version 6 addresses are displayed as a group of 8 four-digit hexadecimal numbers. If you have any leading zeros in a group of 4 digits, they can be dropped. For an example, all the zeros displayed in red can be removed, giving us the following address. Note that if there are 4 zeros in a group, the address gets reduced to 1 zero. There must be at least one number in each group of 4. IP version 6 can be reduced down even further. If you have multiple groups of 4 together, they can be reduced down to a double colon. Notice the original 8 zeros in the address have been reduced down to a single double colon. Notice, however, that the group of zeros at the end of the address cannot be reduced. You can only perform this step once per IP address. I could reduce the other set of zeros like this. This address is still valid. However, reducing the first set of zeros makes the address shorter. If I were to reduce all zeros to double colons, the address would be invalid. Remember this when you are studying for your exam. It will help you remove a few wrong answers. As stated, the host ID and the network ID are both 64 bits. There is always a subnet section of 64 bits, and unlike IP version 4, you don't need to worry about subnetting on the binary level. You will sometimes see the syntax as the IP version 6 address followed by a slash and the number of bits used. Unlike IP version 4 addresses, this value is used by routing or to represent a range of IP addresses. Because of this reason, this value normally only gets set on routers and not on the client computer. If you are confused about this, always set this value to 64, the halfway point in the address. Once you get your head around the syntax of IP version 6 addresses, they do become less confusing. The first type of address that IP version 6 offers is the global unicast address. These are equivalent to IP version 4 public addresses. These are used by the Internet Assigned Numbers Authority, so you are guaranteed the address will be unique and routable on the Internet. Global unicast addresses are hierarchically based and thus greatly reduce the route tables on Internet backbone routers, one of the goals of IP version 6. You can tell a global unicast address as the address always starts with the bits 001, or to think of it another way, they always start with a value between 2000 and 3FFF. If we have a closer look at the bit layout of the global unicast address, we see the first three bits are 001, followed by the global routing prefix, which is assigned by the Internet Assigned Numbers Authority. The next 16 bits are allocated to a subnet. The subnet part is assigned by your ISP or your company, independent of the Internet Assigned Numbers Authority. The last 64 bits are allocated to the interface ID. This is taken from the MAC address, manually assigned, or randomly generated. As you can see, even just one IP version 6 network address gives you 64 bits of client computers. This is more than enough for any company. You could have one IP address for the entire company and use it worldwide. To help with routing, you simply set the subnet part of the IP address for which network it is on. You no longer have to plan how many or how few clients you will need to have in each network. The next address is the link local address. Link local addresses are automatically configured and applied to your adapter. They always begin with FE80. The host part, or the last 64 bits, is randomly assigned. In some literacy, you may see that the MAC address of the network card is supposed to be part of the interface ID. This is true, but you will find that a lot of operating systems like Windows will use a randomly assigned value rather than use the MAC address. The reason the MAC address may not be used is that it raises privacy concerns. If the MAC address is part of the IP address, it could be used to identify the computer. For this reason, even though a lot of literacy states the interface ID should be generated from the MAC address, you will find in the real world it is often randomly generated. Link local addresses are equivalent to automatic private IP addressing used in IP version 4. When using IP version 4 with Windows, Windows automatically assigns a private IP address which always started with 169.254 when no DHCP server was available. In IP version 4, if your adapter received an IP address from DHCP, this would replace that automatically generated address. In IP version 6, the link local address is always present on your adapter even if you assign a static IP address or have one assigned through DHCP. There is only one valid on the local network and routers will not forward them. IP version 6 uses link local addresses for neighbor discovery. For example, if your computer needed to obtain additional configuration from DHCP, it would use the link local address to communicate with the DHCP server. This helps to eliminate the need for broadcasts on the network. The big difference with link local addresses is that you have a zone ID. The zone ID identifies the link the data will be sent over. Each adapter gets one link local address and a unique zone ID. To identify which network to send the data over, the zone ID is used. The syntax is IP address percentage size and then zone ID. Link local addresses are a bit confusing. To better understand, I will go through pinging another computer using its link local address. First of all, from the command prompt, I will run ipconfig to show the adapters on this computer and their IP addresses. This computer has two different network adapters connected to two different networks. Notice that both addresses end with the percentage sign and a number. The number is the zone ID. Both IP addresses are on different networks. However, both have the same network ID of FE80. Since all link local addresses have the same network address, routing is impossible between networks. You will also notice that the network adapter has a static IP address assigned to it. Even though the adapter has this static IP address, the link local address is still present. The link local address is still used for local neighbor discovery and other functions, even with the presence of a static or dynamic IP address. If I now try to ping another computer on my network, you will notice the request times out. This is because the ping request was sent out through the wrong adapter. Since all link local addresses have the same network ID, Windows did not know which adapter was the correct adapter to send the request through. If I now add %10 to the end of the ping command, in other words, send the ping out through the adapter with the zone ID of 10, I now get a response back from the other computer. Remember this important fact about zone IDs. The zone ID only determines which local interface to send the data through. It has nothing to do with the remote computer's IP address and nothing to do with subnetting. In the real world, Windows should determine the correct interface to send data out of. In some rare troubleshooting scenarios, you may need to use a zone ID. The last type of IP version 6 address is unique local address. These addresses are equivalent to the private address ranges in IP version 4. These addresses are for private network use only and thus not routable on the internet. All unique local addresses start with FD, so they are easy to identify. The format of the address is as follows. You will notice the format is very similar to that of global addresses. The address scheme gives you 40 bits to define your network and 16 bits to define your subnets. Each private address gives you 64 bits of client address, which is more than enough for any network. Using the global ID and subnet ID, you are free to divide your network up into a simple and logical network. There are three additional addresses for IP version 6. The first is the loopback address. This is used to test the network stack to make sure it is loaded and working. It is simply ::1. To test the network stack from the command line, run the command ping ::1. If you receive a response back, the network stack is working. This test only tests that the software is loaded and working. If your network card is not plugged into the network, you will still get a response back. The next address is Unicast. The Unicast address allows many hosts or interfaces to have the same IP address. When you attempt to contact one of these hosts, the traffic will be directed to the host that is closest. The address itself uses a standard Unicast address. For this to work, however, your network does need to have Unicast compatible routers. Next, you have multicast address. Any data sent to a multicast address is sent to many different hosts. These addresses will start with FF. Multicast is generally used for data streaming. IP version 6 addresses have what is called a state. The terminology is a little confusing. To make it simpler, think of it as a life cycle. The IP address starts its life off as tentative. In this brief period of the IP address's life, the computer will check the network for duplicates. If no duplicates are found, the IP address changes its state to preferred. When the IP address is first created, the router, DHCP server, or auto configuration will give the IP address a time to live. The preferred state is used for the lifetime of the IP address. The IP address state will change to deprecated once the lifetime of the address has expired. All existing communication will still work. However, no new communication will be allowed to use this IP address. Just remember this. As long as your IP address stays preferred, you should not have any problems. At first, IP version 6 can be a bit hard to understand and, especially with the longer addresses, can be a bit daunting. IP version 6 has been slow to take off, but it is here to stay. Each day, more and more devices and software are supporting it. However, if you are running Windows XP, the operating system will preference IP version 4 over IP version 6. If you are running Windows Server 2008, Windows Vista, or Windows 7, it will preference IP version 6. What this means is if the operating system is not sure which protocol to use, it will use the preferred one. For example, if you attempt to ping another computer on your network when not using a DNS server, don't be surprised if you receive a response back from the IP version 6 address. When Windows did not know the IP address of the computer, it found it using IP version 6 network discovery. Even if you are only using IP version 4 addresses, it is a good idea to keep IP version 6 enabled and running. Network discovery is only one of the services for which Windows will use IP version 6.